America's finest city. What a gorgeous afternoon for baseball we have in store from Petco Park. Ought to be a good one here between the Miami Marlins and the San Diego Padres. It's time for Padres baseball. Next. Joe Musgrove, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Well, as you can see, he's a tall drink of water out there, especially on the mound. That can really work to your advantage because you work on more of a downhill plane and you typically get more extension to the plate on your release. The key, though, is that he has to be out front with his release point or he'll be more likely to miss up in the zone.
And stepping in, Jazz Chisholm. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. And two now as that one's fouled off. Weather not much of an issue tonight. A mild 65 degrees here at game time. Fastball laid off well below the knees.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Left fielder giving chase. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
Batting second, the shortstop, Miguel Rojas.
Ready now for the Marlins, Miguel Rojas. On the ground to the right side, scooped up on to first, and there are two down. Now to the plate, here is Ryan Anderson.
Ryan Anderson.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Top of the first just underway at Petco Park. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. And now the Friars will get their first chance, no score. Zach Thompson, a right-hander from the state of Texas, is the man on the mound here. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Well, Matt, the first thing we're going to find out is how well this guy pitches with little sleep. I can't imagine knowing that you're going to be the next day starting pitcher the night before. This is a young guy making his first start. Listen, you can only make your debut one time, so there has to be lots going on in this guy's mind. Hopefully he can settle down early and pitch well in his debut.
So here's Adam Frazier. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Lifted the other way out to left center. And that's in there. Base hit.
Hey, this game's starting off exactly the way they want it to. Lead off single in the bottom of the first. After their pitcher went out there and threw a donut on the board, boys are flying around.
Into the box, Jake Cronenworth. And he fouls this one off. Grounded to third. This could be two. To second for one. To Aguilar for the double play.
Batting third. The third baseman.
Time now to check the hometown Padres lineup card in this one. What's the key for a home victory tonight, D-Row?
Well, Matty, we know this is a pitcher's park. The numbers bear it out. Look for the managers to play a part in this one. Hopefully the guys listened in the hitters meeting. They're going to stay up the middle, big part of the yard. But when they get on, look for some wheels in motion, some execution, trying to manufacture some runs. I think that's how this
drives it the other way to deep right. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
It's always nice to get something cooking in the first inning, even with two outs. Now your cleanup man steps to the plate and has a chance to drive in the first run of the game.
Stepping in now, Eric Hosmer on the ground softly towards second. He's got it. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Padres leave one. We are still scoreless. Second inning set to go. And up next will be the power-hitting first baseman, Big Jesus Aguilar. A 2-1 home.
Hey, that's just a nice get me over curveball there to steal a strike. I don't think he was looking for that one.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Next to stand in is Jorge Alfaro. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
That's ball two. I got 2-1 the count.
And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Every pitcher looks to get off to a good start. I'd say he's off to a good start. How about the first five batters he's faced? Three of them he sent down via the strikeout.
Into the box now, Brian De La Cruz. Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitching.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. So a pitching clinic there as he sets him down in order, all via the punch out. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, Tommy Pham. The 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Chisholm is there. Makes the play, one away.
Batting sixth, the center fielder, Trent Grisham.
No one on with one down, and that brings up Trent Grisham. The 1-2 misses, ball two. Hit hard up the middle, and that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
Here's a look over to first. Runner back standing. And another throw over. And a dive, but he's back in. Standing in now, Will Myers. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base. Almost like a hybrid pitch out. Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
the 3-1. And he misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away.
Batting eight, the catcher, Austin.
So now here is Austin Nola looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. Bottom of the second here with no score. It's a 2-2 count to the Padres catcher.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
3-2 now.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Got him.
Big strikeout for the second out there, but he's not out of it yet. We'll see if he can feed off
batting
that
nine.
K, wiggle out
no
the
pitcher.
Jam, and keep this game no. tied.
Musgrove.
In now, Joe Musgrove. Hit to short. Reined in. First, and the Padre threat goes by the boards as that ends the inning. Clearly enjoying their time here at the ballpark, as are we. Two complete, still scoreless here on the show. Into the box, Lewis Brinson, 7-8-9, bottom of the order, set to go here in the third. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses for the second ball.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
3-1 to the Marlins left fielder. The 3-1. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch-outs and working on number five.
Fouled away. Fouled off. And it's fouled away. The 3-2 one more time. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Well, in a scoreless game, you want to do anything you can to jumpstart your offense. With the speed of this guy on first, don't be surprised if he gets the green light here.
Up next from Miami, Magnera Sierra. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Popped him up. Over to the left, but playable over in foul ground. And he'll lunge forward to make the catch for the first out.
Batting nine.
So now the pitcher, Zach Thompson. Zach. This is a textbook sacrifice situation, so let's see if that's the call. And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. And that's the second out.
The batter number two.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Jazz Chisholm. He flied out leading off the ball game. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
Wow, what makes it so tough to be a hitter is to be able to hit and change his speeds, right? You're geared up for the fastball, and all of a sudden, he pulls the string and throws you the straight change, the dreaded equalizer.
Grisham makes the catch to end the inning. One left for Miami. Home half of the third coming up, no score. Bottom of the third now, and set to go is the second baseman, Adam Frazier. The 1-1. Pulled toward right center field. Sierra's on his horse. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
The batter number 9.
Digging in now for San Diego, Jake Cronenworth. Bottom of inning number 3, 0-0 our score. Hit back up the middle. And that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit.
Boy, that's a really good pitch, Mark, right there. Down in the zone. That's when, as a pitcher, you just kind of have to shake your head and tip your cap to the batter.
Yeah, right there. You're looking to just either foul that off or stay in there and survive. He found a way to not only stay in there and survive, but drive it up the middle for a knock.
So now to the plate, Manny Machado, skied into straightaway right. De La Cruz is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Now batting.
Runner at first with two gone. And standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Cronenworth leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Throw over to the bag, and he'll dive back in safely. Got him swinging, and that's the third out. One left for San Diego. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Now into the box, Miguel Rojas comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
There's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
Oh, you have to love. You know, Matt, we have so many of these games that are 12 to 10 and 9 to 8. It's nice to see a low scoring pitcher's duel for once.
And he lays off there, ball 4. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number 4.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Next to hit is Brian Anderson, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
I'm pretty surprised by the location on those last 3 pitches. The book on him is that he hits the way pitch pretty well, and he just saw 3 in a row out there.
So does he go back out there again?
No, Matt, I expect him to mix it up. Most catchers won't call for the same location over and over and over.
Over to Hosmer, a double play.
Now back. Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the 2-ball.
At the plate now, Jesus Aguilar. Swing and a line drive, but this will get foul. It's a ball and 2 strikes.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing.
Swing and a high fly ball out to left field. Racing back the left fielder. And that one is gone on a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. A solo shot here to left as the Marlins will take a 1-0 lead.
Only the first hit of the night, but it was a big one. He absolutely punished that mistake, and you have to wonder if that will open the floodgates a little.
Stepping in now, Jorge Alfaro. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Some success with two away, and the top of the fourth is still alive.
Now batting, right fielder, Ryan De La Cruz.
Into the box, Brian De La Cruz lifted in the air out towards left center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Marlins are on the board first thanks to the solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 1-0 Miami. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Tommy Pham. Now the 1-1 pitch. Taken on the outside corner for strike two. And the knuckle curve freezes him as he becomes out number one.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
At the plate, Trent Grisham. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And he fouls this one off. No runs, four hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Will Meyer.
In now, Will Myers. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. A payoff pitch one more time. High in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The next 3-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really...
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for San Diego. They're down 1-0. Ready to go in the top of the fifth. And next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Lewis Brinson. The 1-1 home. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. After it is Myers. He gets there and makes the play for the first out.
Now batting.
Now to the plate, Magnera Sierra. He's 0-for-1 thus far. One run, two hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, Matty, he's had these guys on a proverbial rocking horse all night. Changing speeds, hitting every quadrant. He's tough to hit.
And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
To the plate now, Zach Thompson. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. But sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
3-1 to him now. Two out, nobody on. lofted in the air out toward right center. Center fielder on the run. He can't get to it. This one's down. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. One hit in the inning, but that gets erased. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Marlins 1 and the Padres nothing. And back at Petco Park in San Diego as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Digging in will be Austin Nola. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch-outs will stick with you a little longer.
And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. One pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2.
This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making contact, let alone putting the ball in play.
The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Man, he is looking flat out unhittable on the mound right now. That's now five straight punch outs. I love it, but I think he might want to get his defense involved at some point so they don't fall asleep.
At the plate now, Joe Musgrove, and the Padres pitcher behind with a 1-2 count. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll continue this roll he's on. Make it 6 strikeouts in a row. Gracious, 2 away. Good job of making him chase a pitch
now
for the
Matt,
strikeout there.
Baseman.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
So now to the plate, Adam Frazier lifted down the line and left. But this will wind up being a foul ball.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from 5 shutout innings.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Brinson is there, and he'll put it away to retire the side. Nothing across here this half of the inning. 5 innings complete. Miami's out in front, 1-0. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Jazz Chisholm. He flew out in his last AB. 1-1 is crushed to straightaway center. No doubt about this one. That ball is gone. So it's a solo shot to dead center, and the Marlins have taken a 2-0 lead.
Yeah, I can remember when leadoff hitters were these little speedy guys who would try to leg out little numbers or draw walks. Well, that time has passed, and guys like this, with pop at the plate, can sometimes go deep as well as anybody in the lineup.
Into the box, Miguel Rojas. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
Fouled away. Here's another 2-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Full count still.
Hey, that's just a great mix of pitches right there, and that's what this guy's going to do if he's going to keep this team off balance.
locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Fouled off. Popped him up.
Cronenworth
backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out.
The batter.
Next to dig in, Brian Anderson. One run in and one gone so far this inning. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And it's fouled away. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. Swing and a liner. And that's into the outfield for a one-out hit.
Sometimes you just got to trust your hands. That pitch probably not wasn't bad. Even in the zone, and he was able to fight it off for a base hit.
Now the skipper of the Padres is up out of the dugout on his way to the mound, and it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision. Craig Stammen enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning.
Number 34, Craig Stammen.
Stepping in now, Jesus Aguilar. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Long run for the center fielder. He gets there, and that's the second out. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and up next will be the big catcher, Jorge Alfaro. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. And strike three called as he says, "You got to be kidding me," with the side retired. But the Marlins tack on one more courtesy of the solo home run. Bottom of the sixth coming up. It's now 2-0 Miami. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that'll bring up Jake Cronenworth. This one's down to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
Up next,
and in steps Manny Machado. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point.
Machado.
One out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. Fly ball to straightaway left. Waiting on it is Brinson, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. First baseman now Eric Hosmer is in, and
baseman.
Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three-up, three-down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. The count now at 2-1. Hit out toward second. Scooped up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. We're through six full. The Marlins on top, 2-0. all set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring forth the rookie outfielder, Brian De La Cruz. The 2-1 is strike two swinging.
Two balls, two strikes.
Here now, the 2-2 is laid off, and the count runs full.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Now the payoff pitch home is a called third strike down in the zone.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Standing in now, Lewis Brinson. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. All even now, 2-2. The pitch. Bases are empty, one man out. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him. He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
In now, Magnera Sierra. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Sent on the ground out to second. Reined in over to first, and that retires the side. Miami down in order as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Ready now is Tommy Pham. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Now a swing and an easy fly ball out toward right center. Sierra is there, and he has it for the first out.
The center fielder.
And the hit will be Trent Grisham. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
You know, Matty, tough to go down looking right there, especially in a long at bat. I kind of tip my hat to the fact that he didn't go into uber swing mode. He battled. He just got locked up. Look for him to have another quality AB. I think he's seeing the ball pretty darn big right now.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
Wow, that's one of the toughest pitches in baseball to hit, right? That good straight changeup, El Cambio. There's not much you can do with that. You're going off of that arm speed and the ball, it just doesn't get there.
To the plate now, Will Myers. Outside, 2-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline.
Boy, he's been great in this one. He's only one strike away from putting another zero on the scoreboard.
This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Count still full, 3-2. Another payoff pitch. And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Dylan Floro will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Monte Harrison is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. Next to the plate for the Padres, Austin Nola. Lifetime versus this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Throw over to first, and he's back standing. Myers is off of first with two away. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
A couple of strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Good spot for the change there, and that'll knock things up at 2-2.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him on the board with a swing like that one.
And this is swung on and missed, though he will need to do a little housekeeping at first. And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. Good work there from the Miami bullpen. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. The Marlins lead this one 2-0. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Austin Adams will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jake Mariznick will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. So that'll bring in Monte Harrison next, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Sent on the ground out to second. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first out. Jazz Chisholm will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle inning. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Up next to the moment.
So the next to bat will be Miguel Rojas. Flew out last time up. Two out, nobody on. And he'll try to hold back on the pitch inside, but he pretty clearly broke the plane that time. It's strike two. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up.
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Marlins, but they're on top 2-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Jake Mariznick. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1.
This offense has been underachieving all day, putting way too much pressure on their own pitching staff. Someone has to have a quality AB and get this line going.
3-2 pitch. Gets him looking, strike three.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job baseman. Not to give in and at battle back to earn the strikeout.
Frazier.
That's not always easy to do.
So now to the plate, Adam Frazier. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Harrison is there now, and he has it, two gone.
The batter number 9.
So next to bat will be Jake Cronenworth. His prior history in this matchup, just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. This one's flared toward left center. Rojas has it, and that retires the side. Padres down in order. They're down 2-0. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Brian Anderson. Now the 1-1 pitch is laid off for ball two. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Another try at 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
At the plate now, Jesus Aguilar. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo, up and in.
Fouled away. Here's another 1-2. A swing and a miss for out number two, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch, and for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Into the box now, Jorge Alfaro. Lifted down the line in left. And it's a foul ball. He'll try it again, 3-2. And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. Miami down in order. They're up 2-0. Anthony Bass comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
Miami, number 52, Anthony Bass.
Here's Manny Machado now. And Dan, what's gone wrong for this lineup today? They're only three outs away from being shut out.
Well, you know, I just haven't seen a lot of fight in these at-bats. Now, of course, plenty of credit goes to that pitching, but the effort on the offensive side has been pretty lethargic watching from up here in the booth, Matt.
Yeah, I would imagine it feels the same from watching in the stands in this one. One and two now. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
The 2-2 doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Yeah, well, down two. You better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tied run to the plate.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Fouled off. Another full count pitch home. He's at the knees and called strike three.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces,
now batting,
everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
The 1-1 home is looked at for ball number two. Hosmer in front, now a 3-1 count.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Harrison is there, and quickly two are gone here, and it's not looking good for the home nine. Next, here is Tommy Pham, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. San Diego down to their final strike, and it's fouled away. One strike from a shutout. Here it comes. Hard hit towards center. But this is taken in as a perfect metaphor to end this one, as that ball was hit hard, but the ball game is over. This evening's game finishes 2-0 the final score. Miami took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Zach Thompson takes home the win. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First, for the victorious Miami Marlins, 2 runs on 5 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base.